Alright, today we're going to do 1-5 adding integers and 1-6 subtracting integers. In doing this, we're going to take and apply the multiplying and dividing integers rules that we learned in our previous lesson. Definition: additive inverses is a number's opposite. For example, negative 5 and 5 are additive inverses of each other. A zero pair is a number and its opposite. 5 and negative 5 are zero pairs. Let's go back and look at something here real quick. The difference between the two is additive inverse. The additive inverse of 5 is a single number. The additive inverse of negative 5 is just 5. Okay? However, the zero pair is both numbers combined. It's both 5 and negative 5. The additive inverse, the answer is one number. A zero pair is both of them, the two numbers that come together to equal 0. 5 minus 5 equals 0. Now I take this and repeat it out loud. I know you're probably either sitting in your room or you're maybe sitting at the kitchen table or this computer in the living room, but I still want you to start singing this stuff out loud. Your parents are going to look at you kind of weird and think that strange things are happening to you, but it will help you to do this. Now, if you're sitting in my class or somebody else's class looking at this, probably don't want to start singing this stuff out loud, because we don't mind your parents looking at you like you're funny, but the teachers may just whop you upside the head if you do that. So moving forward, if signs are the same, you find the sum. If signs are different, you find the difference. Say it again. If signs are the same, you find the sum. Again, if signs are different, you find the difference. If signs are the same, you find the sum. If signs are different, find the difference. Let's go back. Say that a couple more times. If signs are the same, find the sum. If signs are different, find the difference. Keep saying that to yourself out loud. Say it over and over and over until it's burned into your brain. Now write this problem down. Don't jump in and work it yet, because there's a particular way I want to go about this. Something's going to really help you to learn these problems. Now in this problem, you got negative 2 plus another negative number, negative 1. Negative plus a negative. Now if we were multiplying those, we would have said negative times the negative is a positive, but we're not multiplying them. Instead, we're going to take and add these, and we're going to start off with a situation that I refer to as the ugly problem. The ugly problem occurs any time, let me get my pen going here, any time you've got that situation right there, a sign beside a sign. Here you've got a positive directly beside a negative. Yeah, there's some parentheses between them, but they're still sign. There's no number separating them. Whenever you see that situation, you're going to do step one. And step one says to take and multiply the signs. And what did we learn a positive times a negative was yesterday? Positive times a negative is a negative. So those two signs came together in order to give you a negative. As far as we are concerned, this part of the problem is gone. We will never look back at it. Everything we will do from here forward applies only to that next line. So now we have these two numbers together, a negative 2 minus 1, and that leads to the poetry we did earlier. It says that if the signs are the same, find the sum. If signs are different, find the difference. So you need to look and say, are these signs the same or are they different? Well, they look an awful lot alike to me. Now somebody's, I'm sure, thinking, well, this one's negative and that one's minus. A negative and a minus are the same thing. I'm going to say that one more time in English so everybody understands. A negative and a minus are the same thing. Okay? Therefore, looking at this, our signs are going to meet the same category. And there it goes again. Let's take and let's see, but ask me again. Don't show that message again. There we go. Now, let's see if I can get rid of that nasty mark that just popped up there. Okay, our signs are the same, so we're going to find the sum. What's the sum of 2 and 1? Well, the sum of 2 and 1 is going to be 3. So we're going to take and put that 3 in there. And then next, the sign in front of the largest number goes in front of your answer. So which number is larger, a 2 or a 1? Remember, we're not looking at this right now. I don't care about the signs, I just care about the absolute value of the numbers. Which one is larger, a 2 or a 1? 2 is. What's in front of that 2? A negative sign. Therefore, we're going to take and put a negative in front of our answer, giving us a negative 3 for our solution. So let's look at a different problem here. Now we've got 7 plus a negative 9. Here we got a positive number, and we're adding a negative number to it, and we're starting off once again with the ugly problem scenario. Since we have the ugly problem scenario, we're going to multiply the signs first. A positive times a negative is a negative. So that's the same thing as saying 7 minus 9. Then we're going to go straight to the next one. If signs are the same, find the sum. If signs are different, find the difference. What kind of sign is in front of this 7 right here? It's an invisible plus sign. So my signs in this case are going to be different. One's positive, one is negative. Therefore, we're going to take, let me back up for just a second here. We're going to take and say if the signs are different, we're going to find the difference. And the difference between 7 and 9 is going to be 2. Now remember, for step 3, we don't care about this top line here. It's done. All we're looking at is what's going on down here. The sign in front of the larger number goes in front of your answer. Which number is bigger, 7 or 9? 9 is bigger. I don't care about positives and negatives. 9 is bigger. We're dealing with absolute values. Since 9 is bigger, we're going to take its sign, stick it over here in front of the 2, so that our final solution is going to be a negative 2. Easy, easy math. Anybody can do this stuff. Here's another one. Negative 4 plus 8. Step 1 says to multiply the signs, but the multiplying signs only applies to the ugly problem situation. We don't have the ugly problem going on here. Since we don't have the ugly problem, whatever should we do about step 1? I know, let's skip it. Let's go straight to step 2. Step 2 says if signs are the same, find the sum. If signs are different, find the difference. Are they the same or are they different? In this case, our signs are going to be different, so we're going to find the difference. The difference between 4 and 8 is 4. And then step 3, the sign in front of your larger number goes in front of your answer. 8 has the largest absolute value. It is positive, so our answer is going to be positive 4, and you're done. And notice you don't have to put that plus sign in front of the 4. If the sign is not listed, we automatically assume the number is going to be positive. Now you take a break, pause the recording, and work on that one. Okay, let's see what you came up with. Ugly problem situation, multiply your signs, positive times the negative is a negative. Signs are different, find the difference. Sign in front of your largest number goes in front of your answer, negative 2. Easy. Now do that. I know it looks the same, it's not. Something's different, look close, pause the recording. All right, this one, ugly problem situation. Multiply your signs. Positive times a negative is a negative. Now we have signs are the same, so we're going to find the sum. And then the sign in front of the larger number, that's 4. It's going to go in front of your answer, so it's going to be a negative 6. Easy math. And then right here, you got negative 2 plus 4. This one, pause the recording and work as well. All right, this one, is not an ugly problem scenario. So we're going to skip step one. Don't worry about multiplying the signs. Go straight to step two. Step two says signs are the same, find the sum. If signs are different, find the different. These signs are different, the difference is 2. And then sign in front of your largest number goes in front of your answer, positive 2. Easy math. Chapter 1, Section 6, subtracting integers. Guess what? It works just like the adding integers does. Same exact rules. So with that in mind, try working that problem on your own. Alright, hopefully you paused the recording and did that. We're starting off with an ugly problem scenario here. You got the negative and the negative. Negative times a negative equals a positive, so that's just 3 plus 3. And I mean, if you really required using steps 2 and 3 to solve that one, go for it. Signs are the same, find the sum, sign in front of a larger number goes in front of your answer. Excuse me, big yawn. 6 is your final solution. Pause recording and work on that one. Alright, signs are the same. Ugly problem. Signs are the same. Find the sum. Shoot, my bad. Multiply the signs. Negative times the negative is positive. And now it's just 13 plus 6. 19. Easy math. Try that one. Alright, multiply your signs. Negative times the negative is positive. Now we got a little bit more challenge going on. Step 2. Signs are different, so we're going to find the difference. And then the sign from the largest number, your largest absolute value, belongs to 13. It's negative, so we're going to put a negative in front of our 7. Easy math. And here we go, negative 13 minus 6. Pause it and work on that one. Alright, this one was not an ugly problem, so we did not do step 1. We did not multiply the signs. We go straight to step 2. Signs are the same, so we're going to find the sum. The sum of 13 and 6 is 19. Sign in front of your largest number. Larger number is 13. It's negative. Negative 19 is our answer. Easy math. Your opportunity to expand your mind tonight. It's worksheet 1516. Get hot.
He's mastered the art of the trick shot. The Evel Knievel jump. Five rails and into the cup. The deadly ricochet combo, followed by a kiss off the eight. And while this pool shark's one of the best, he's not exactly what you think. Because believe it or not, he's only 7 years old.
Now what do you think about that?
Pretty good, Landon.
It's a game. I'm good at lots of them, but I'm the best at pool.
He's Landon Shuffit, a first grader from Greensburg, Kentucky. And this pool-playing prodigy started when he was still in diapers.
I set up a shot for Landon to shoot, and he just shot the ball in the pocket. I realized that there was something extraordinary about his ability.
Seeing Landon's obvious interest, his father, Stan, began teaching his toddler the basics. Eventually, he even entered Landon in tournaments against grown-up pool players.
Well, I just played a game with a 7-year-old and I've just lost.
And besides his habit of regularly sinking adult competitors, Landon is best known for his grab bag of impressive trick shots.
Like it.
Starting out, he warms up with the machine gun. Without missing a beat, Landon moves on to the lazy man's rack. Then it's the clothes hanger. This one's called the stack of two railroad shots. And Landon came up with it all on his own.
I want to know all the trick shots.
But this pint-sized prince of the pool table's most impressive trick shot is the one he can always bank on. Landon will attempt to hit this dime with the cue ball and then land the coin inside a shot glass. But to do it, he must hit the ball with perfect accuracy and just the right amount of force. Landon is ready. He carefully aims and fires the cue ball. Hitting the rail, he sends the dime airborne, and unbelievably, it actually lands in the glass. It's all in a day's work for this little trick shot kid.
I wouldn't say I'm real good, but I'm pretty good.
Only 7 years old, this pool-playing whiz just keeps getting better and better. Always moving toward his goal, one day, turning pro.
I would.